Oh, I thought I heard a noise. Greetings, traveler. It is very nice to see you. I have to confess that considering the way things have gone lately, it's nice to see anybody. But please don't stand out here in the cold. Please, please come in and share my fire with me. According to scripture, after Moses came down from the mountain, he wrote other things, and after his addition to the Book of Knowledge, he wandered away and was never seen again. Well, recently I've had an encounter where I could have never been seen again. I had a health crisis. I was taken from work to the hospital on Tuesday in an ambulance because I thought I was having a heart attack. So I ended up being in a contest. And it's a contest that everyone will lose eventually, but at least this time I won. I stared death in the face. He turned away. People at the hospital were very surprised at my attitude, and I wasn't surprised because I knew that there was nothing I could do about it. I have made the choice to walk this lone path, and it has been very gratifying. My spiritual and mental states are both highly positive, so there is no stress in my life. And although, as I've said before, I'm my own doctor and my own physical therapist, well, I can't whittle on my own heart. I'll leave that to the professionals. So, since I wasn't really worried about what was going on, I was able to focus on other matters. I remember that Tuesday afternoon, I was sitting there and I had the remote right in my hands, but I never touched the remote to turn on the television. Why? I have better things to do. And I remember after I turned away from watching TV that I was inspired. I wrote 27 stanzas of haiku spontaneously. And when I posted it on Facebook, I called my health crisis a speed bump. And besides surprising the medical staff there at St. Alphonsus, I even surprised myself. I decided, well, I need to practice. So I practiced a little astral projection. I focused through my third eye and manifested my astral form, and I fell asleep. A while later, I saw a flash like I do with a precognitive event, and then I woke up and I said, what? Why did things look so strange? And then I realized, just for a moment, I saw my body in the hospital bed, and I was looking from off in my astral form. I said, oh, okay, that's cool. Let's see. Oh, and the next morning, I'm a morning person, and even though I did not have my work alarm, I woke up at 03:30, as usual. So I was laying there, and finally about 6 o'clock, the CNA comes in to take my vitals. And she does her deal, and she's like, oh my goodness, your blood pressure is 141 over something. We need to take that again. And I'm thinking, wow, what? I'm not upset, you know, wonder what's going on. The reading had never been that high since I had been admitted. 130. 132 was the highest before. So, I focused for maybe 15 seconds and did a relaxation exercise. And then she immediately took it again. The reading was 90 over 60. It's almost a shock to see these extra sensory type skills that I possessed, but in the past sometimes seemed to be so difficult to perform. Now I'm doing them almost effortlessly. And, it's like I said before, when I think it's not going to get any better, the next day shows up. So, I did a stress test. And it's not your daddy's stress test with you walking on the treadmill. They just inject you with a chemical. And it was a slightly schizophrenic experience because I was laying there trying to relax, and I was, but I suddenly was twitchy, and it's like, man, I feel like I should be running around the building or something. So I was monitored you know, lots of quality care and attention. And I have minor EKG irregularities, and my cholesterol is not where it should be. Other than that, no restrictions, no medication. However, I have discovered a disturbing side effect. Now, I don't know if this is just because mentally I've adjusted to being off schedule because my supervisor gave me the rest of the week off, but my endurance, one of the things that defined me, seems to have evaporated. I barely walk somewhere, and I'm suddenly winded. I'm sitting doing nothing and I'm getting winded. It's crazy. It's irritating, but I'm not worried because I have the 411 to work myself back into shape. Maybe it's just a reminder that I need to slow down a little and use what little time I have left efficiently. You know, I have been ranting like this in order to get my head right to be a teacher. You know, it's my full intention to do exercise videos, instructional videos, sharing access with my friends in the counterculture community, art, athletics, music. And I thought the last video, it's like, man, you know, I've purged, I'm ready, I can continue to march. And then this hell speed bump shows up. Now, I am not disturbed by this. There are so many times when I could have been dead already. And I don't know why. If I may be so bold as to slip into conservative Christian talk here, I don't know why God has seen fit to bless me in my last days like this. But I'm not complaining, you know. And it's almost shocking to see, despite your own difficulties, your dreams come true. An example, my friend who's in hospice. I went by to visit and there was that reaction. Are you a llama? Are you a minister? But no. And it was interesting, but I had to process it, and then it correlated, and the thought actually woke me up this morning when I was trying to get back to sleep. Is that you're not trying. No, the thing I'm trying to do now is have a positive attitude about me and it seems like I'm now radiating this positive energy to people around me. And as I was correlating this, that, you know, after it woke me up out of a sound sleep, I was like, you know, I grew up without a lot of physical affection. So I made sure I gave my son a lot of hugs when he was growing up. And I wanted that when I was married too, but the ex-wife thought every attempt at intimacy or just closeness was an attempt to initiate sex. Well, early on, sure, but not always. And it was, unfortunate that I did not have that happen. But now it seems that I'm giving off that good vibe that, it seemed like before I would have to hug someone to do it, and now I don't have to hug them. Like, transcended physical contact is just, wow. So, since I think I'm almost ready, I did want to share with you about the rule of three and how that sort of came about. I remember way back in the day, Reader's Digest, and I always wondered, how could they take parts out of the book and still have it make sense? You know, a condensed book, that's crazy. You can't take words out of a sentence and have it mean the same thing. But somehow it seemed to work. And I learned how, studying, to take notes efficiently. And eventually I developed a skill where I could extract essential information and distill it down to maybe just a page or two. And I also learned that you could take some situation and you could boil it down in its essence to three items of information that would describe it well enough for you to do what you needed to do. So, for example, that, you know, a person consists of three parts: the physical, the mental, and the spiritual. And this was not something that I extensively researched, to be in agreement with some other mystics. It's like, back in the day, there was very little information on skills and stuff like this available. So it is gratifying to see the information repeated elsewhere. So, how about on the job? You have tools with work instructions, parts, and your own skill. So, I originally called my entity a development center, but then, it was before I realized the balance concept. Well, my friend, I have to admit, my path has been a convoluted one. It might have given a GPS fit back in the day. But I thought about it, and you can't change the past. And it is your struggle and triumph over your demons from the past that has made you a stronger person. It is your knowledge that you gained in the past that gives you the ability to cope with the present. And it is always being open to learning something new that enhances you now and in the future. And one thing that it has been enhanced now that I have taken this path deliberately in my last days is that sometimes you can only count on yourself. I said a while back on Facebook, but I don't know if I said here, that I've embraced the principles of the Burning Man. I encourage you to go to the Burning Man website to see what they're up to. And it's a nice set of philosophical principles. The one that caught my attention was gifting. Here's that description. Burning Man is devoted to acts of gift giving. The value of a gift is unconditional. Gifting does not contemplate a return or an exchange for something of equal value. Now, I've also been a substitute teacher. I have taught every grade from kindergarten through high school. I've taught in the resource room. I've taught special needs kids. I've even taught at the juvenile hall where substitutes don't want to go. So, now you're probably scratching your head saying, what could possibly be the connection? How can you swirl this together and have it make sense? Well, I don't know how, but that's sort of what I do. I take stuff and I look at it differently. I take stuff that shouldn't be combined together and make them work. So now, the act of gifting, especially as an old person, the most valuable thing you can give is your time, because it's a rapidly diminishing non-renewable resource. And combine that with my love of teaching, and enhanced by my red pill wisdom, which I gained from repeated contact with you brothers, and we have the path for my future. And to have everything align the way it has, it's almost overwhelming. But I must emphasize, without the red pill wisdom, I would have no idea of this path, and I never would have reached my full potential. That is why I'm here. That is why I'm bearing my soul. That is why I'm paying it forward. Well, visitor, it certainly has been a pleasure. Oh, you know, I was talking to some of my, as close friends as I have now, about what's going to happen after my physical form is dead here. And I told them, oh, I've got it. Don't waste money on a traditional funeral. Ew. No one needs to look at my shriveled up corpse. Don't cremate me either. That's a waste. No. Now, after you whittle away all the worthwhile organs you can take from me, I'm gone. I have no need for them. Now, I saw this somewhere, and I hope this is still a deal. This company has a process where they will freeze-dry you, your body, and eventually condense you into a nutrient block, which will then be fertilizer for a tree. And I read that, and I was like, for a moment I thought it was weird, but then I was like, well, you know, there's a lot of people here, and we don't have room to bury everybody the conventional way, and it's so expensive. And after going to a former supervisor's memorial party, it's like, yeah, that's the way I want to go out. I mean, you show up, you listen to some of my music, have some of my liquor, but because, you know, this is all paid for by me because I'm saving for just that eventuality. You know, tell some lies. Tell about some time I did something, you know. Have fun. Have a good time. Take home a souvenir that reminds you of me. Now that... That is a memorial party, you know. That's, you know, that people having a good time. No crying. No wailing. No, none of that stuff. No, that's undignified. That's unnecessary. You don't need to wail over an empty shell. Well, I thought that was a little interesting tidbit I'd share with you. So, visitor, you know, I thought I was done with the psychological nudity, but you know, I got a little reminder this week that I've got a bit more to go. So, I have added another, tagline to my signature phrase here. The one you see is still effective, but I've got a front half now. Seneca the Younger said, "You should live every day as though it was your last." And it's pretty sound advice. With the knowledge I've gained from you, brethren, being able to live in the moment, because now I'm cultivating stoic and zen qualities that I guess were there, but suppressed. You know, life is a joy now. And I'm sharing that joy with others, and it's a great way to get to the finish line. So, you know, as they said back in the day, today is a good day to die. Now, I would prefer it not happen. You know, because I have work to do, but if it does, it does. And remember, traveler, as you go on your way, I still say some of the best days of your life haven't happened yet.